So this is a mock-up. The building in the state that it's in right now is being framed, and all the electrical boxes and the roughing is starting to occur. But this is in advance of that. So we take it a little bit further up front, mock it all up to be sure we can bring some of the staff in and we got it right before we do it 64 more times. And the medical gases, the vacuum, the oxygen, the emergency power, the normal power, and all the critical functions to support our patients are within this wall. That wall is typically prefabricated off-site. It's done in a clean environment, it's done at a safe work level, and then they're brought here to be assembled on-site. And up above us here are structural steel support systems for all the mechanical, electrical, and plumbing needs. Off-site, during the construction of the steel in erection here, the heating hot water, the ductwork, the conduits, all the air distribution that serves this room, the bed lift support systems, they were all prefabricated in these long racks above me here, and they were brought on site and erected and hoisted up. A hospital is one of the only unique buildings that is designed to be occupied during a disaster. We are supposed to be able to evacuate one compartment and find refuge in another compartment. And to be able to do that, there's many codes and requirements put in place for that to be successful. So the location of what kind of pipe, what kind of power, how it's protected, the protective measures are very prescriptive. Our ceiling heights are very compacted. We have a lot to fit in there. If it wasn't for the technology with the 3D modeling that we have today, it would be really challenging to fit well. Years past, it was the first trade-in had the most space, and each trade thereafter had to make it fit. And with the 3D modeling capabilities we have today, all the trades can agree upon space constraints up front. It's modeled, everything's decided where it's going to go, there's less waste, and they can cram all of these systems into a space that will still be serviceable down the road. So right now we're standing in the central utility plant. This is the heart of the building, essentially. The boilers that make all of our hot water, our steam, the chillers that provide cooling to the building, they make cooled water that they pump out to the building and it comes back. The electrical distribution was pre-modeled, and all the pipes are here ready coming out of the floor for distribution gear to be set. But this is all modeled in a three-dimensional model right now. Every pipe, nut, bolt is known where it's going to go.